We're back. Welcome to Off the Shelf Reviews, where we provide real-world reviews of primarily 1/6 scale collectible figures. So, what are we looking at today? The TB League, or Fison, 1/6 scale Anubis, Guardian of the Underworld figure. As usual, we'll discuss why this piece belongs in a collection, likes and dislikes, and then we'll rate the piece as a top shelf, middle shelf, or bottom shelf collectible. So let's get started. At Off the Shelf Reviews, we give you the most realistic in-hand look at these pieces so that you know what to expect if you decide to acquire them for your collection. That means no light boxes, no studios, and as usual, I maintain a focal length and depth of field that best mimic the human eyesight. But before we talk about the figure itself, a quick word on the packaging. The box is actually really nicely done, very thick cardboard, and it has a magnet-attached front flap. So there's magnets on the sides of the box, and this front flap peels off very easily, and it provides access to the figure and accessories. Everything is packed in soft but supportive foam sponge, and then the figure itself comes, really just comes as a partially dressed body with everything else separated. Now, for those of you who don't recognize this character, you may be asking, you know, what the hell is this? Or more importantly, why would you want to own this in your collection?
Why? Why is that, sir?
Quick history lesson. In ancient Egyptian religion and mythology, Anubis was the terrifying, canine-headed god who presided over the mummification of bodies and guarded funerals. He was typically depicted as a seated black jackal, or a man with the head of a jackal. And for most of the Old Kingdom, Anubis was the most important funerary deity, the god of death, and his image can widely be seen in royal tombs or in the entryways of non-royal tombs. By the end of the 3rd millennium BC, the Egyptian god Osiris had become the king of the dead, and Anubis was relegated to being the god who invented mummification, and also known as the master of secrets. Anubis is one of the most widely recognized ancient Egyptian deities, mostly due to his fascinating appearance, and he has appeared in many pop culture media such as books, comics, TV shows, and films. If you are interested in Egyptian mythology, or mythology in general, Anubis is arguably one of the most iconic ancient deities from any culture in history.
So back to the figure. Initially released in 2019 and then subsequently re-released for a second run in 2020, Anubis was the first figure in TB League's Egyptian God line. Now, I'm not sure if that's what they're actually calling the line, but I'm calling it that. And they've subsequently also expanded this line into 1/12 scale figures. They've shown three other figures so far for this line, with the second figure, Horus, reaching collectors' greedy hands over the last couple months. As previously mentioned, the figure is packaged with a naked torso and upper body, and then the pleated and belted linen skirt and gladiator-style sandals and feet, those are already attached on the figure. But the heads, the hands, and any other clothing or costume accessories are packaged separately. So what you're seeing here is the figure fully dressed. So what do we like about it?
So what do we like? Apologies for having to make a switch to a voiceover. I was having some issues with the original audio. But let's start with the head sculpts. Plural, that's right, this figure does come with two head sculpts. The first is more of a stoic, intense expression, and the second head sculpt has a much more aggressive look. Both are beautifully done, with excellent paint, particularly around the eyes and the makeup around the eyes, as well as great sculpt detail and paint in the headdress. You have real metal earrings on both head sculpts as well. So here's a quick look at the back of the head sculpt. So this is the headdress. Again, great detail and great paintwork. The more aggressive head sculpt adds further detail in the snout and the teeth. You can really see the skin sort of being pulled back from the growling mouth. And there's great detail and paintwork on the teeth. And as well, the color of both the hard plastic head sculpts perfectly match the color of the silicone skin on the body. And speaking of the body is actually what TB League Fison are really known for. So T.B. League initially began creating realistic, muscular human bodies primarily as a tool for artists and art students, so that they could have a model with which to practice drawing or photography or sculpting the human form. So these bodies feature a stainless steel skeleton with 28 points of articulation wrapped in a non-toxic, environmentally friendly silicone muscular body. T.B. League truly is the best in the industry at seamless bodies, and the articulation and the durability is unmatched. All other seamless bodies, whether they're made by Hot Toys or Enerbay or third-party manufacturers, they all seem to have quite a high risk of tearing or deterioration over time. But T.B. League Fison bodies are simply of a higher quality. Due to the steel endoskeleton, this is quite a heavy figure, but it holds all poses very well, whether they're museum poses or something much more dynamic. You can see great separation and definition in the musculature, as well as some vascularity in the shoulders, the biceps, as well as the forearm. I also should mention that this was T.B. League's first body of this color, this sort of black color, and it's important to note that the body has not been painted. The coloring is actually added during the silicone manufacturing process, so there's no concern about the color rubbing off or staining any of the clothing. One last thing to mention is that all T.B. League bodies come with a light dusting of powder, which is there to keep the silicone from getting sticky. You can blow it off with compressed air or wipe it off if you want. I usually just leave it to come off naturally. And he comes with 3 pairs of hands for different poses and accessories. And also, he stands at about 12.4 inches tall. So it
now
scales very nicely.
I don't normally do this in my reviews. Yeah. And this is certainly not going to be a full sort of articulation session. But I just wanted to do a quick demonstration for those who have never owned or handled a T.B. League or Fison body before. So this body is based on the M35 body, which is their most muscular body. And as you can see, when you start to sort of pose the figure, the muscles will move and flex, I don't want to say as realistic as possible, but surprisingly realistic for a 1/6 scale figure. It's really, really well done. And as I mentioned, even though other figure companies, see, like, look at the way that it twists. And I mean, even though other figure companies have made seamless bodies before, or at the very, you know, at the very least seamless arms, no one has really been able to do it quite like T.B. League or Fison. And I really believe that it's because this was designed not as a figure. Initially, it was designed as a tool for art students. And so I think there was just a lot more effort and thought and even science behind it, as opposed to some of the sort of 1/6 scale figure bodies. The outfit is, again, very well done by T.B. League. So there's a linen skirt, as well as linen wraps around the arms, linen wraps around the shins, and all the linen sort of has a frayed and slightly distressed look, which I think is meant to mimic the linen wrappings on mummies. He's wearing a broad collar, which I believe is called a Yusek or Wessek, and is very nicely detailed and painted. In fact, all of the plastic costume accessories, such as these armlets, these spiked forearm gauntlets, I'll just turn this around so you can get a better look at these. Incredible detail. The detail on the belt. Even these metal chains hanging from the belt. And then even the detail on the gladiator-style sandals, all very, very well done. Well painted, well sculpted, just beautiful detail. Fantastic job. And I think it's fair to say that T.B. League has always done a fantastic job on the outfit details. It's a very, you know, T.B. League is a very underrated 1/6 scale manufacturer. For accessories, I would list the second head sculpt as an accessory, which is excellent. As I previously mentioned, this figure does come with 3 pairs of hands, which I'm not really going to show you here because they are hands. I should mention the hands themselves are nicely done. They have a sort of a claw-style fingers with big nails, which, you know, are really suitable for a canine character, canine-based character. As far as the other accessories, he does come with a large ankh on a chain, which is the Egyptian mythology symbol for life or everlasting life, is what they believe. He also comes with the nechaka, I believe it's called. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but basically it's just a flail, which normally would be held by pharaohs or kings. And the flail represents the fertility of the land and the food which the pharaohs provide to the population. But it is an odd choice as far as an accessory for this particular character. But I think it's because when they initially put this figure out or developed it or produced it, I don't think they were planning on doing an entire line. And therefore, they were just looking for iconic sort of symbols that you'd see around ancient Egypt. Now, lastly, he comes with this very, very long staff. So this staff is quite a bit taller than the figure itself. The head of the staff, although very, very well executed, again, the paint and sculpt is beautiful. But the head of the staff is not any sort of symbol that I'm aware of when it comes to Egyptian mythology. But I think it's just sort of simply designed to match the character himself. As mentioned, all of the accessories are just very, very well done, very well sculpted, and very well painted. Now, lastly, what I really do like about this figure is that it's not a typical sort of Marvel Cinematic Universe or Star Wars figure, which means it can be displayed as a cultural display piece just about anywhere in your home. Now on to the dislikes. There are very, very few dislikes for this figure, if any, and quite frankly, my dislikes are really just nitpicking at this point, but I'll get to it anyway. So one of the things I find that I dislike about the figure is that TB League figures can be very challenging to put together. As mentioned, this figure only comes partially dressed with partial accessories on the figure already, and you'll find that with most TB League figures. And I guess that's just given, it's just to give you the option of how you want to display your piece. But it can be very, very challenging. So for example, these earrings are actually soft plastic. And the little green circle is a soft plastic spike. So the earrings come like this, separate from the head sculpt. And you have to put the spike through the hole here. And then you have to put the entire spike with the earring attached through the hole in the ear to complete this look. And that was exceptionally hard to do and very, very frustrating. It's a very tight hole to place these earrings into. And the pressure required certainly puts a lot of stress not only on the earring, but also puts the head sculpt at risk. The other dislike I have is that this figure does not come with a stand of any kind. The stand which you can see here that I've been using for this review is actually a custom stand that I purchased off of eBay, but I just feel like 1/6 scale figures should come with figure stands. But other than that, that's really all that I have for dislikes. Right, now it's time to rate this figure, but first, the shelf pose. Oh yeah. Just a relatively simple pose with Anubis looking very regal. But back to the ratings. So my collection is based on nostalgia and my childhood during the late 70s and early 80s. And when my brother and I visited Washington, D.C. as children, after a day spent at the Smithsonian Institute and their Egyptian display, my dad bought us a book on King Tut, or I believe properly pronounced Tutankhamun. So not only did the book and the treasures shown in the book capture the imagination, but there was still at the time a lot of rumors around the curse of the pharaohs and how many of the individuals who discovered King Tut's tomb had died under mysterious circumstances. And since then, I've always had a fascination with ancient Egyptian mythology. And this culminated in a recent trip to Egypt where my wife and I spent several weeks visiting archaeological sites all around the country. So for me, this figure was a must-have, and I'm very excited about TB Lee continuing this line. The interesting and unique design, combined with the best seamless bodies in the business, along with great sculpting and paintwork, means that this figure is truly a top-shelf collectible. Let me know if you agree in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want, and stick around till the end of the video for a quick preview of the next review. But for now, it's time to get this collectible back on the shelf.
Justice.
Pum 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 pum. Pum 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 pum.